Now I know what it takes. I'm putting a new face on the old one, ready for anything. Playing with fate, not a moment too late. Showing the whole world.
Julie, I envy you. Oh, I envy you. If I had a husband been gone over 3 months and we're coming home today, oh, I envy you. How does everything look?
Perfect.
But I don't think Jonathan is gonna wanna sit that far away from you. There.
Now, if we're gonna sit that close together, we might as well sit in one chair.
You're right.
Please, put that back. I want to be a little ladylike.
Oh, please, Julie. This is no time to be a lady. The only lady that Jonathan has seen in the past 3 months is a Mexican donkey named Lupe.
Yeah, well, I wish that were true. There was a girl in his archaeology group, Linda Barnes. I saw her in a picture he sent.
You mean the blonde sitting on the donkey?
It's hard to believe she wants to be an archaeologist, too. I mean, she had laugh lines, she looked fun, she was gorgeous.
Oh, please, honey, Jonathan doesn't go for that type. No, I mean, Jonathan goes for brains, not beauty. No, that's not, no. See, if you take a girl like that, thank heavens, Jonathan is home.
Now he's early, I'm not dressed yet. What am I gonna do?
Light the candles, wet your lips, pucker up, and he'll never remember that girl on the donkey.
No!
Jonathan! Hey. Oh, Jonathan!
I don't care what Julie said in her letters. You look terrific.
Oh, I know that.
I missed you.
I missed you, too. Let me look at you. Oh, Jonathan, honey, you didn't eat enough.
Anna, that's not it at all. In the jungle, where the temperature is 105 degrees, you lose water retention. And then...
Hi. Julie, Jonathan is home.
Ooh, young love. So glad you're home early. We're having dinner in the room so you can tell me all about your trip. How was it?
Hey, Jonathan, let's go outside and break the pinata you brought me.
Okay, I'd love
to,
Joey.
Jonathan!
Oh, you look good. I think he missed me.
Jonathan, we're having dinner in the room!
I ate on the plane.
Will you shut up, Addie? Just listen to me. He says that in the jungle, you lose water retention. I tell you, God, I got to get to that jungle. Hold on, wait a minute. Hey, what's wrong with you?
Jonathan doesn't want to eat in the room. He'd rather catch up with the family. What am I, a pen pal?
Honey, I better call you back, okay?
No! Look what Jonathan brought me. Just beautiful.
Oh, why, if it isn't the world's oldest bullfighter.
I may get a date with Elena Salcido after all. Say, did you take a lot of pictures down there? I can't wait to see what the Yucatan looks like.
I didn't take any pictures. It was boring. Believe me, the whole trip was a waste of time.
Digging up graves in the jungle is boring.
Take it from me, folks. Dead people are overrated.
Must have been the beautiful baby. Jonathan, look.
Oh, that's nice. Take a look at this. What do you think? I just finished.
Oh, that's beautiful. Did you put it together from that kit?
Yep.
Oh, wow. Put this crib together in 2 hours. How long did it take you?
3 days. But it's a lot cheaper than buying it in a store. And you know now, with the money I save making things myself, I could pay back every cent I owe.
Jonathan,
including
please,
the $500 you lent me to go to Mexico.
Just take it as a gift, okay?
I don't want a gift. I want to pay back the money I owe.
But, honey, I'm not worried about it.
Nell, let's get this straight. I am not a freeloader.
Jonathan, listen. You are also not a crib builder.
That's real funny now.
Just kidding.
I'm gonna put this thing back together, and I'll pay you back every cent I owe you.
I'm just kidding. Jonathan, wait a minute. Yeah. Jonathan! Jonathan! Jonathan, please. Oh, Jonathan. Look, Jonathan, if it'll make you feel any better, I'll let you pay me back the money, okay? It's only $500.
Nell, to me, $500 is the national debt.
Take as long as you like. A dollar a year would be nice. Hi, baby. How was school?
Oh, it was okay, but I'm late for work.
What? Didn't you tell them at the bookstore that you're quitting?
No, Jonathan, I told you that I decided to keep working.
Julie, honey, I'm working 15 hours a week for Luigi's. You're gonna have a baby. You should not be working. And you should be off of your feet. Now, I could double my time at Luigi's for extra money.
Jonathan, how are you gonna double your time? Don't you have to go back to school?
I'm going back when I go back. I am not a child now. I do not have to explain everything to you. Oh, I forgot. This is not my house. I'm just a guest in this house. I'll try and treat it like a hotel.
Kaniski Hilton, this is the desk clerk speaking. Yes, Jonathan is here. 1 minute. It's Jason Butler.
I'm not here.
Come on.
No!
Jason, could I please take a message? Yeah? Okay. All right. Okay. Listen, there's going to be a reunion for your archaeology class Saturday at 8. Be there.
Oh, great. I'll wear that Indian dress you brought me.
We're not going.
What?
I have to work.
On Saturday night?
Yes, sweetheart. I am working. Make up your mind, Julie. Do you want a husband or a party animal?
Jonathan, why are you yelling at Julie? What's wrong with you two having a little fun?
We can't afford to have any fun.
Neither can I, but it never stopped me.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, Jonathan, welcome home. Oh. Well, I guess this must be just about the happiest house in Glenlawn.
I am. Million laughs.
I bet your ears are burning. I just left Professor Randolph, and he told me what a great time you had on the trip. He told me all about the midnight canoe trips you took, and the makeshift laboratory that you built, and the paper you wrote on Hernando Cortez. I'd love to read it.
Cortez was a jerk.
Don't look at me. I'm just a desk clerk. Why don't we go in the kitchen, have a cup of coffee, and leave these two lovebirds alone so they can talk?
Yeah, let's go. Yeah. Just come on.
Jonathan, you told me you spent every night in your tent. What's this about midnight canoe trips?
Well, what is this? Am I on trial?
Oh, I suppose you spent all your time with Linda Barnes. After all, she's gorgeous, beautiful, and fun.
Oh, come on, Julie. You know she's not my type. Oh. I'm going to work now, Julie, so I can put food on the table for you and the baby. That's my job now. Not sitting around here talking about my stupid trip to Mexico.
Told you. Million laughs.
Nell, I'm going over to study at Joanna Kaufman's house.
Okay, come home on time.
I will.
That's 10 o'clock.
Oh, Nell.
My time is your time.
Hi, Nell.
Hi.
Is Jonathan home yet?
No, he's not home from work yet, dear.
Oh.
Julie, can I talk to you for a minute?
Yeah.
Sit down. You know, Julie, I've been awfully worried about you lately. You've been walking around here looking so tired and upset. Anyway, I read this article on pregnant women's calcium needs, and let me get you a glass of milk, okay?
No, I've had it with milk.
Oh, come on. We can make a game out of it. I'll put some chocolate in it.
All right.
Okay. If there's one complete food in the world, it is milk. It's inexpensive, it's cold, and it's white, and we're out of it.
Good, I'll just have the chocolate.
Well, we're out of that, too. Why don't you call Jonathan and ask him to bring a quart of milk home with him?
I don't feel like talking to him right now.
I'll call him myself. You know, Jonathan has been acting awfully strange lately. I'm just glad the baby is not here to see it. Luigi's, can I... No, I don't mind you putting me on hold. They put me on hold. They are playing Volare. I mean, how cornball. Volare. Oh, cantare. Yeah, Luigi. Jonathan, please. Neil Hopper. What? Thank you. Bye-bye.
Is he on his way home? Oh, he's out on delivery. Well, where is he?
Julie, Jonathan didn't go to work today. He called Luigi's and said he was sick.
He lied to me? He lied to Luigi? He lied to me? He's a liar now. I married a liar.
What are you yelling about? I'm the one that loaned him $500. Fun. I could just do this every night, couldn't you? And it's only 12:15. The night is young, and Hawaii is only 9:15.
Hawaii? Are you trying to tell me Jonathan went to Hawaii?
No! I'm not trying to say Jonathan went anywhere. I'm sure there's a perfectly good excuse for his lying like a rug. Ooh, I'm having a good time. Jen.
Can't concentrate now.
That's because you're not trying. Now, that makes the score 1,200 to 7. Which means you owe me 9 cents. Hi, Grandpapa. Did you have a good time with the bird watchers?
Not exactly, Nell. The Audubon Society just doesn't know how to party.
That old man didn't go to any Audubon Society. Did you see the spots on his tie? He's been to mud wrestling again.
Now, where's the milk?
Oh, pipe down! Grandpa, there is no milk. And I would appreciate if you would not use the word milk in front of Julie.
Why not?
Well, earlier I tried to call Jonathan and ask him to bring some milk home from work. Then we find out he didn't even go to work. He lied to Julie. He lied to Luigi's and told him he was sick. Now she's sitting up waiting for him. I'm just sick about the whole thing.
Is there any ice cream?
No. Grandpa, I'm worried about John. You know how funny he's been acting lately. I think he's having an affair with Linda Barnes.
These brownies fresh.
Did you hear what I just said? I said, I think he's having an affair with Linda Barnes.
There's no reason why he can't pick up a quart of milk on his way home.
Hi, Grandpa.
Look what I found. Some brownies. Here, have one. Okay.
You know what, Nell?
What, baby?
I bet Jonathan is having an affair with
you. Don't be ridiculous, baby. That's Jonathan. Now act like you're happy to see him, okay?
I'm not happy to see him.
Oh, come on. Just surprise him. Samantha Kaniski? What are you doing coming home at 12:15 in the a.m.?
Nell, I had no idea it was that late. My watch stopped.
Tell me what time your watch stopped, and you better be telling me the truth.
12:15.
Sam, you told me you were going to be studying with Joanna Kaufman.
No, I was.
Where are your books?
Oh, I must have left them in Eric's car. I hope he puts the top up.
Eric?
Yes, Eric Stabler. Now, I had no idea she was going to invite him and Larry Connors to help us. They're honor students. So, to thank them for all of their help, we asked them out for dinner, and the drive-in movie didn't let out till 12.
No drive-in movie?
No, there was no place still open for a hamburger, really.
All right, baby. Here's your watch. Good night. And you're grounded for 2 weeks.
Okay, sorry. Good night.
Hold it! What do you think I am? You think I just got off the Greyhound bus with a chicken? I just grounded you for 2 weeks and you tell me, okay, I'm sorry, good night. What is that?
Larry and Eric are going to Colorado for 2 weeks, so I won't be missing much.
Okay, babe. Good night.
Good night.
Sam, just consider this like a 2 weeks notice, okay? You're grounded the minute they come back into town.
Hell!
Go there! I don't know what's gotten into that girl. She's starting to act like me when I was her age. Well, actually, 12:15 is a little early. My clock didn't stop to 2. Oh, Julie. Julie!
Sorry, Nell. I just can't figure out what's wrong with Jonathan. Maybe he is having an affair with Linda Barnes.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. If he were really having an affair, he'd be home by now. Samantha, why are you up?
Oh, hi, Nell. Isn't there any milk?
No, there is no milk! What is it with this family? All you ever think about is milk, 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 milk! What you want me to buy a cow? Are you up at 3 o'clock in the morning?
Well, I just couldn't sleep.
Me neither. I had this terrible nightmare. I dreamed that Jonathan was in Mexico, and he was watching Hallie's comic, and he was on this donkey with 4 beautiful blonde girls. And before I could ask him which one was Linda Barnes, I fell into this human sacrifice pool. Fortunately, the natives recognized me as their queen. So they pulled me out, and they gave me some milk. Then I had to sing 4 choruses of Get Down, Get Down, and voila, I just woke up.
That is a crazy dream.
Yeah.
Good night.
Night.
Good morning, Nell.
Why, Jonathan, you're just in time for breakfast.
Oh, I ate in Bakersfield.
Wait a minute, Jonathan. You went all the way to Bakersfield for breakfast? What's the matter? You don't like my cooking?
No, that's not it. The car broke down on the way back.
Ah, well, in the interest of time, I'm going to pretend that I believe that, okay?
I'm not making it up now. Oh. I'm quitting school.
What?
Quitting school and taking Julie to Bakersfield. I'm going to run a computer in a chalk factory.
A chalk factory?
It's not as bad as it sounds. It's not just white chalk. They've added a lot of new colors. Pastels. I think it's going to be exciting.
Jonathan, would you do me a favor? Can you just sit down with me for a little while? Please? Jonathan, I want you to tell me what really went on down there in Mexico.
It was the most thrilling experience of my life.
Oh. So that's why you don't want to be an archaeologist anymore, right?
Nell, Julie is having a baby. We're still living like kids here with you. I can't make enough money at Luigi's to support all three of us. And I don't want her to work. She's done enough for me already.
Oh, so that's what's bothering you.
Gotta act like a responsible husband now. I've gotta go out there and earn a living.
Oh, Jonathan, if you run out of money, you know I'll help you.
I already owe you $500.
No. You owe me $500.09. The wife is a lousy gin player. Want a cup of coffee?
Yeah, thanks. And no milk.
I wouldn't even worry about it.
I don't know what happened, Nell. Last year at this time, I was a senior in high school. And now I've got a baby on the way. How did it happen?
You know, Jonathan, I know this is a big responsibility, but it is not the end of the world. The end of the world is having to do something that you hate and having to give up something that you really love, like archaeology. Dig?
Yeah, I dig. But how could I afford to spend another 3 years in college? I've got Julie and the baby to think of.
I think you were selling Julie short.
What do you mean?
But Jonathan, when Julie married you, I don't think she was expecting to move into a mansion. She married you because of who you are and what you're going to be. And if you don't make it as an archaeologist, then you can go and work in that chalk factory. Joey could use the colors.
I really missed you, Nell.
Missed you too. Don't hug me, go hug your wife. She's gonna make you one of those overrated dead people.
And when we opened the tombs and saw those drawings on the walls, I tell you, Julie, it was like magic. I've never been so excited in my life.
Never?
Well, maybe once.
I know why you're so scared, Jonathan. Well, this is a big change for me, too. I've never had a baby before. Or a husband. It's a lot harder than we thought it was gonna be.
Who thought about it?
Are you sorry we got married?
No.
Are you sorry about the baby?
No. I like the idea of being a father more than anything. But I'd be lying if I said I thought it'd be easy.
Jonathan?
Yeah?
We are gonna make this work, aren't we?
Of course we're gonna make it work. And Julie, as soon as the baby's born, we're gonna move into our own place. Deal?
It's a deal. As soon as we figure out how to get the baby away from Nell.